Welcome to the demo on product search using large language models. To give you an overview on what you will see, I'll search for chipotle salsa. I will get chipotle salsa, but I will also get completely different products which do not have to do with chipotle salsa but are related. And this can help customers discover different products very rapidly and can also mean big business for retailers. And this magic happens due to large language models. If you want to try out the demo, you can do it on my platform experiencedatascience.com. So let's get started. Let me start by showing you the demo on my platform experiencedatascience.com. I will go ahead and select the demo product search using large language models. We'll be using a data set on grocery products. So let me select it and copy it to my data. Now let me select it and let us first see what is inside the data. I will select few records to display and all the columns, and let me now run. Alright, so the data has got grocery product names. You can see that there can be very long product names. Alright, so now let us now go to the next step of text clustering using large language models. But let me first explain what I mean in simple English. We are going to take all the product names and then send it to OpenAI, which is the company behind ChatGPT. And it has created the most powerful large language model called GPT. The large language model will convert each product name into numeric representation, also called as embeddings. We will project this numeric representation on a two-dimensional plot, and then you'll see that the products which have similar context appear close to each other. For example, the whole wheat tortillas and whole wheat pita bread are close to each other. Salted caramel fiber bar and coconut chocolate energy bar are also close to each other in the embedding space. We can even make clusters of similar products. Now let us see this in action. I will select the product name for clustering, as well as I will make some other settings. Let us try to make 5 clusters. We will use OpenAI as a way to create the embeddings. I will save the results because we are going to use it in the next step. Now let me run this. Alright, so our embedding space is now created. Each dot is a product, and let us hover over a few of them to see what they are. So here you see green chili anytime sauce, and you also see its numeric representation. Now let us see what is the product next to it, and we see that it is medium taqueria style chipotle salsa. So even if both the products have completely different description, they are very close to each other because they are related. And this is the power of large language models. Now my friends, let us now go to the next step of product search. And let me first explain how it works. So we will type in a search term. We can then get the numeric representation of the search term using OpenAI. And now the numeric representation of the search term and the products in our embedding space both are vectors. So we can do a vector distance calculation to find the nearest products. Now let us see this in action. Let me first start by changing the data set, and I will select the data set which was generated as a result of clustering. Now let me go to the text search and let me enter chipotle salsa. I will also make some other settings, and let us say we want the 5 closer products, and let us run and see what we get. Alright my friends, I see chipotle salsa, but I also see other products which are close to chipotle salsa in the embedding space. Now, as a consumer, this is helping me to discover more products very rapidly. And the customer is also tempted to buy them all. So this is also a big business for the retailers. All right, my friends, I encourage you to try out this demo, like as well as comment on the video, and see you soon in the next video.